Hey guys, happy New Year's. I can't believe that it is 2019. That is just so crazy to me. But I hope every single one of you guys had a great New Year's. I wish you guys the best this year. I hope you have new goals, new adventures, and so on. But let's get into this video. If you guys don't follow me on Instagram, you guys should go ahead and follow me on Instagram. I posted the other day that I was at Ulta and I only went for one thing. And I decided to ask, you know, how many points do I have? Because I've been shopping all last year there and I need to know how many points I have. Well, I don't remember exactly how many points I had, but it equaled to $250 that I can use. And I was just like, whoa, because I was not expecting it. I only went for one thing, and then someone tells you, hey girl, you got $250 that you can use on makeup and stuff. I was like, ooh, what do I need to buy? So I can either A, save it, 2, spend it, or 3, just use some of it. But you know, I need to treat myself. My birthday's in January 6th, and I need to go ahead and shop around. So I went ahead and I spent it all. So here I have 2 bags full of Ulta items. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what I got. First item here is this Revlon straightener. Now this retails for $29.99 and it looks like this. Now they have so many straighteners, but I wasn't gonna spend all my money on just a straightener. Like, I hardly ever straighten my hair, but my hair is so frizzy. Especially the ends are like fried out, looking really gross, and I am gonna get a haircut this month. But I wanted to get a straightener because mine had broken and I need something to help smooth out my ends, because that is where my most, what's the word I'm looking for? Basically, my ends are where I need the straightener, because I usually just wave or curl my hair. So $29.99, I like this size. I don't like the ones that are a little thicker. I just feel like this is great for somebody who has a little bit, you know, shorter hair, that you're just trying to focus more on the ends. So I haven't tried it. I don't know what's gonna be like, but I just need a straightener. Neutrogena wipes. I always need these makeup remover wipes. These are one of my favorite ones, and this retails for like $12.49 when you buy 2. Now I know that the price can change depending where you go, whether that be CVS, Walgreens, Ulta, Walmart, all of that, but these makeup wipes, you can't go wrong. Here I have this Garnier. This is supposed to be like a miracle cleansing water. It's supposed to help remove your eye makeup. This is the one that also removes waterproof. Now this retails for $3.99. I've used this before, specifically when I used to work at Walgreens, and I actually really like this stuff, but I haven't used it in a really long time. And I saw a video of somebody putting like a bowl full of hot water with dirty beauty blenders, and they also pour some of this and they left it there for a little bit, and then they were all super super clean. So I'm gonna go ahead and give that a try. You guys know if it works or not, but this is the main reason why I got this. Now this is what I originally went to the store for. This is the NYX Tinted Brow Mascara, and this is the NYX Eyebrow Pencil. Now this retails for $8, this retails for $10. Now I have been wearing a lot of wigs lately, so this is the reason why I went, because I have a blonde wig and I need something like blonde, because I only have brown or dark brown eyebrow pencils. So yeah, this stuff, I haven't used their actual pencil, so I'll let you know about that. But I have the brown one that I use, and I just love this stuff so much. And for $8, you have so much product in here. It has lasted me a really, really long time, so definitely recommend this. I also got the good old Urban Decay All Nighter Spray. You guys already know this is amazing. It retails for $32, and well, you know, if I got $250, I gotta buy this stuff. I also got these Morphe liquid lipsticks. Now, I love the fact that Ulta carries Morphe. I just love that so much, but I don't think I've ever tried their actual liquid lipsticks. Let me go ahead and swatch for you guys. But first, let me tell you the colors. So I have Nibble, I have Peanut, and I have Bloodshot. So here are the swatches. This first one here is Bloodshot, which is so pretty because it's like a vampy burgundy. Then we have Peanut, which is more like a nude brown. And then we have Nibble, which is more like a chocolate brown. Now these again retail for $10, and I'm so excited because I love liquid lipsticks. So I'll let you guys know how I like these. The rest are just going to be eyeshadow palettes. Now I finally gave in and I bought the Sultry Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. Now this baby is so pretty. The packaging in itself is really nice. I thought that it would be like that nasty glitter that like kind of falls off, but it's not. But I've been excited, I've been wanting this, but at the same time I was like, nah, it's fine, like I'll just buy a different palette. But look at this baby, it is so freaking gorgeous. I know that this is not a new palette, but it's new to me. So, yes, it's this. So, I'm going to go ahead and swatch for you guys so you guys can see how pretty these are in case that you don't have it at home. Here are the swatches. I am obsessed with these colors. I feel like they're going to be good for all skin tones. There's not one color in this palette that I feel like somebody's going to be like, no, I'm not going to use that. I am intimidated by that color. Which is really nice because most palettes have like 1, 2, 3 colors that people are like, no, I'm never going to use that, but I'm going to use every single other one. And you feel like you're not really getting your money's worth. But with this palette, I feel like I'm going to use every single color, which is really freaking awesome. I love that there's mattes and there's also shimmers. So overall, I'm just pretty obsessed with this right now. I can't remember if I already said how much this retails for, but this retails for $45. I also got the Urban Decay Born to Run palette. Now, I've been wanting this for a while now, but it was always sold out. But I love the fact that it's a hard cover. I love the packaging, and I love the fact that there is this big mirror. Like, look at this. And it's heavy, too. But look at the colors. They're so pretty. Let me give you guys swatches. Here are the swatches for this palette. This retails for $49. Now, I'm obsessed, again, with all of these colors. They're all so pretty. I feel like there's a lot of playful colors in here, but yet they're playful enough that every single person would use. They're not too scary looking. They're not crazy brights, and they're not really dark. I am obsessed with every single one of these shades. I definitely can see myself using every single shade in this palette as well, which is really nice because that means I'm getting my money's worth. So again, this retails for $49, and I can't wait to play with this. Also got the 35M Morphe palette. Now, this is what it looks like. It comes in a very hard kind of cover. Oh my god, I'm sorry, that was probably really loud. Is this like nice? You guys like this? But anyways, it comes in a hard cover like this. It says Morphe on the front. And let me show you guys what this looks like. So I actually really wanted this, and I feel like it just reminds me of Halloween. That's the main reason why I wanted this. Like, the greens, the purples, it just reminds me of Halloween, and low-key just reminds me a little bit of the James Charles palette that I don't have and that I really want, and that I hope that I can get it because he's going to restock on January 3rd. If you guys don't follow me on Instagram, you should. But I'm going to try to get it on January 3rd. But anyways, this is the palette. Let me swatch for you guys. So here are the swatches of the 35M Morphe palette. Now, these colors are beautiful. They're definitely more out there, so I feel like not every single person will actually like these. But the colors are so beautiful. There's some that are brighter than others. Some are more glittery than others. I love the fact that there's mattes and there's also shimmers. And I would say that some of them are like metallic-y, but I'm just obsessed overall. This is definitely going to help me be a little bit more playful and definitely going to help me out for Halloween time. So for $24, this is a pretty legit palette. Last item I got is the 35V eyeshadow palette from Morphe. Now this is what it looks like. Basically same packaging as the 35M, hard packaging. And when you open it up, these are the colors that are inside of this palette. So it's kind of similar to the other palette, but I will say that there's more neutral shimmers. There's more of like the brown side. There's more blues. I don't think that one had blues. The other one had just more like greens and purples. Like when you open that palette, that's like the first thing that you'll notice. Versus here, you'll notice right away like the blue, the purple. You'll see how there's like some warm here, and then there's the neutrals here, which is pretty cool. So let me go ahead and swatch this for you guys. Here's the swatches of the 35V Morphe palette. Like I already mentioned before, this has some blues, some purples, some warms, some neutrals. For $24, I feel like this is a pretty good palette. Overall, I'm really happy with everything that I have purchased. I believe I bought 1, 2, 3, 4. I bought 4 eyeshadow palettes. I bought like 3 liquid lipsticks, a setting spray, some makeup remover wipes, some eyebrow stuff. And I don't know what else I bought, but I'm pretty happy with my purchase. So if you are an Ulta Beauty member, remember, use your points at the end of the year or so on, you know, save, and then you'll be able to shop around like me. But yeah, I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, go ahead and hit that like button. It's subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. You're more than welcome to follow me on Instagram and Snapchat. I post little previews here and there of what I'm doing, what I'm filming, and all that goody good stuff. So you're more than welcome to follow me there. Comment down below. Let me know what looks you guys want me to do or what video you guys want me to film next. I'd love to interact with you guys. And I hope you guys all have an amazing beginning of 2019. And we'll see what happens this year. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video.